Hey guys, so from my perspective, I always heard about great names in the past that I always wanted to witness play. And I never had the opportunity to actually see this. So today I got an opportunity to see Vaik Davids. And obviously Mr. Solomon's over here. Put on an excellent performance, excellent chase. The type of cricket that was played. Just talk to me about it. Being here at this age, of course, and putting on a performance like you have. Let's start with that.
Well, you said they put up the performances, so I didn't put up a performance with the bat today, but yeah. I'll accept that my two esteemed players, colleagues, they were brilliant. I think we always knew that they say class is permanent and form is temporary, and that you've noticed today. I think it's not the way they went about batting it. Shows that imagine you've seen them 20, 30 years ago, how they would have performed. I think you, as a young man, haven't seen these two players perform at their best. Today was a glimpse of that. And I think a lot of counterparts, always the Bronze Cricket Association or Union, a lot of them were surprised to see the quality that we possess from the South African Cricket Board. We talk about Vaik, we talk about Mario, but I can tell you there is so many others that haven't had the opportunity today. And as you go along finding out about the South African Cricket Board legends and players that you've only heard about, you'll find out there is so much quality players out there that would have produced on the big stage if they had the opportunity. Let's talk about today. I think Vaik hasn't played for a while. We know he's with the Cobras all the time, but he hasn't played a proper game of cricket. And I don't even think what you saw today was the best of Vaik Davids. I think he's from a playing point of view. I think I mentioned it to you when we were sitting there. From a playing point of view, he's not fit. Mentally, he's fit. So I think he just showed you a bit of what he can do if you get a fully fit Vaik Davids from a playing perspective. Mario Solomons has been playing over 40s veterans cricket now for a while for Montrose. Prior to veterans cricket, Mario also made a name for him with Kells River Cricket Club, Montrose Cricket Club, and in the Western Prawns Cricket Association. He has been absolutely amazing in the over 40s league for Montrose Cricket Club. And with the World Cup looming, I think both of these players have just put up their hand. I know it's early days, but I think South Africa can put a good team out there, and I think this season coming or the next World Cup will be even better from what we can produce out there. I think veterans cricket has taken off as chairman of Western Prawns Veterans Cricket Association and vice chairman of the Veterans Cricket Association of South Africa. There is so much to offer for players that thought that their careers was over. There's so much opportunities now for players over 40s that thought that Saturdays or midweeks they got nothing else to do. There is something to play for, and it's awesome to see that our players of yesteryear can still produce the quality. And I'm not only talking about the players from the ex-Western Prawns Cricket Board. I'm talking about players of the Union, and I think also veterans cricket has brought a lot of camaraderie together. Where ex-players meet each other and just come out and have a good time. But I think veterans cricket is growing around the world. I think South Africa has woken up very late to veterans cricket, but we're on the right track at the moment.
So Vaik, it has been a long time since you've played cricket, and you came out to the middle of the year, put on an excellent performance. Some big shots we saw, some massive sixes, but also some decent fours straight down the ground as well that you played. Running between the wickets as well. We saw some of that happening.
Well, it was a big ask though, because I mean, obviously I haven't been playing, I haven't been on the cricket field for ages. I mean, obviously coaching and throwing balls to professionals is completely different to bowling a ball and obviously batting out there. So it was a magnificent opportunity that I grabbed with both hands today regarding playing with my old colleagues, you know, and it was so good to see them still, you know, obviously doing what they do best, and that is playing cricket, and you can see the skills are still there. We definitely need maybe new bodies, because the bodies are feeling it at this point in time. I mean, 45 overs from me fielding and then batting at the end there, I really, you know, definitely feel it. But it was an amazing day, and I thoroughly enjoyed it. And to see the way Mario played today was exceptional. and the way we paced it. And I think, you know, also just a bit of the experience, you know, knowing that it was no rush to get where we need to get. And we have the ability to hit boundaries, and it just calmed us, you know what I mean? So fantastic, I enjoyed it very, very much today.
What I noticed is when you came into the middle, it took some time just to get in, take a few blocks. So just talk to me about how important that is to set up your innings.
It's massive because, I mean, you know, you don't know what the bowlers are bowling. You don't know the pace of the wicket. You don't know, you know, the action of the bowlers. You need to acclimatize, you know, and that is the best way of doing it. You know, just take a couple of balls, knowing if you are a boundary hitter that you will catch up at the back end of the innings, and it just calms you down, you know, knowing that you don't have to go balls to the wall, you know, immediately.
So an all-round game from you today that I witnessed. Not only did you pull off a reverse sweep, now I've been told that that is something that you've been doing for your whole career when you used to play back in the day as well, but I also got to witness it today, something that's lacking in our game maybe in the new guys, the way the face spin. Can you talk about that, your approach to playing spin?
I always believe the 3 meter line. So if the ball is in the 3 meter line, it's time for me to use my feet, get to the pitch of the ball. Once you get to the pitch of the ball, it can't turn, and then you can play the ball wherever you want to play. Anything shorter than that 3 meter line, I will rock back or pull, back foot down or square cut. So I think it's important when playing spin is also to rotate the strike. I think I did it well today, rotating the strike, right? Getting to the other side.
What was also particularly important to you was also you lost a partner or so, and then Mr. Vahey came into the crease and you guys built an amazing partnership. What is key about that? What type of conversation do you have with your partner to say, look here, we must take this game home?
And I think me and Vicky spoke about it, you know, rotating the strike, as I said, at that time, getting about 3-4 runs over. Like for Ix said, we had the ability to get boundaries at the end, last 5 overs, and I think that is